for a year now. And today's the day. Yeah. Holy Spirit said, I'm sitting there and he said, turn it over, bud.
You want to pass the Kleenex?
Yes, Lord, just fill it this morning. Give it the strength.
I got to the same purpose of all today. I thank God for His church.
Yeah.
I'm talking about the kind of church that we've got here today, kids, bring.
Yes.
People are free to do it, to say that, that they feel like never. Oh, I've experienced it so much down through life that I go to a strange place, maybe. God bless me a lot with the whole lot of revivals, and I go to a strange place. And I can have the Spirit, and that church would pick it up. And if you stand up to me, life just where you're standing, between God and you, I'm standing here today. And our pastor stands here each service. And we need the Spirit of God. We need the love that the church has got, that we could share it out with them and say things that would be a blessing to them, and that were along the line. I just thank God for His church today. Yes. They're scattered all over this land and country. There ain't nothing no sweeter, nothing no greater than God's people.
Amen.
That'll obey the Spirit.
Amen.
In the last few verses of this book of St. John, and the book of St. John, the last few verses of that chapter, you'll find the story of a man that went to Jesus and to ask that Jesus would come down to his house to heal his son. And I thought of this some time back again, but I often wondered why that the services, the prayers are not answered, and services are not spiritual, and the prayers are not answered of God's people. And this story that I was mentioning to, you'll find these words in there that Jesus said to him. He said, except ye see with signs and wonders, you will not believe. The man said, help thou my unbelief.
Yeah.
We need to believe God today. That's the thing that I want to talk about for a few minutes. It'll be for a short time, we can see that now. But anyhow, when we believe God, all things are possible.
Yeah.
Yeah. The Bible tells us that. Let's believe it.
Yes.
Believe God, believe in Him. The little things that you might do. Let me use myself, if you will. Back 1949, somewhere was a long night, I felt the call to preach. God called me to preach. I'd say, God, I can't go. I'm not educated. I can't talk like other people. There's a crowd or a coward. All of these things. Jesus would say, bud, go, and I'll go with you.
Yes, amen.
Amen.
Go, and I'll go with you. I heard that so many, many times. And when I finally come to the place, it's a long story and I'm not going to tell it off. I won't give out the Bible. When I finally come to the place in life that God showed me, what was going to happen, that I could believe, then I I could take him by the hand and say, come on, Jesus.
Yes.
Let's go. Come down to my house. Yes. Help me along life's pathway.
Yes.
Oh, hallelujah. Bless me. Down through the years. And how they let me see things come to pass that beyond understanding. This service this morning is beyond understanding. The Spirit of God is here.
Yes.
But if you and I would only believe the power of God, let me mention a place or two in the Bible where people believe God. If you remember the story of Saul, Paul, when he shipwrecked under, now the people that was on the boat and all of that, they begin to get off and the things that they done died. He said, now wait a minute. He said, after a long absence, listen to me this morning, children. It's time that America today and Atkins Chapel today spend some time out yonder in a long absence with you and God.
Amen.
We need you today.
Yes.
Put him first.
Yes.
Thanks so much. The storm is so strong today.
Oh,
all of you know I live by myself and all of that. That's beside the picture in the planet. But I have a long time to study and to see things to kind of save our country at the end of the day. But after a long absence, just me and God, I can sit down and talk to him.
Yes.
I'll see the condition that our country's in today. It's come home to us, just up and down the road on each side that people have left out the power of God and salvation by our grace, and that the people needs to be saved.
Yes.
What I'm trying to say is this, when this disease come around, whatever you call it, there's a preachers on the radio, TV. I watch a lot of TV. Not much preachers. I don't believe what the preachers talk with. But they get got on the TV and they preach on how to deal with revelations, and there wasn't nothing wrong with that whatsoever. It's God's word. I don't mean it in a critical way, but they missed the mark. They failed to believe God that he was here and answer our prayers. They will preach on what they think is going to happen when Jesus or this thing one time winds up and all of that. But they didn't stop and think about that time was short. That's what they were trying to prove. But that poor old lost sinner that's outside the somewhere that don't know God, they missed the mark. Our job today is to tell the world about Jesus.
Amen.
Yes.
That he still owns and rules and reigns today.
Yes.
That we believe God and that he'll go with us when we go.
Yes.
When we go, yeah, Paul said, thou to them said, now if you don't stay with the ship, you know, we need to stay with it today. That old path that Jesus planned, it told us to seek out and walk thyly in. Not the new modern way. To say, I don't mean to be critical today. I guess I've got a right to, though, don't you?
Yes.
I'm the oldest one here. That we need to see the lost and dying world.
Right.
This poison stuff, as far as I'm concerned, that going on today, they'll take a little child, get him up and say a little prayer to him, read the Bible, ask him if he believes in God. Well, sure he does. All of us believe in God naturally. But I'm talking about spiritually. Something's got power, something that life, on and on and on and on.
Yes,
right.
Yeah.
The way to it. The way to it. No, Paul told them, say, take your little meeting now. You need some strength. It's time that we get a hold of the Spirit of God. We need strength from God today. Not the world. Not what some professor had fixed all up and tell us that this Bible and it's true. Not all of that. We believe there's only one thing to believe, and that is Jesus Christ died for our sins and made it possible that we could be saved and go to heaven when this world comes to an end.
Yes.
Amen.
Yeah.
How great it is today. Yes, it takes it to me. He gained them strength. Thank God today for the Spirit.
Yes.
That we can feel you in this place. Gain a little strength. I gain a little strength every time I get to come. Yeah, I do. That helped me believe God. He said, I tell you, he said, never all will make it to land. Boy, could you? I can preach a week on that. We're going to make it to land, but the old ship, we ain't going to, I see it's going to fall apart. It's on natural land. It should fall apart some of these days, not long with me. You don't like this today or tomorrow. Next week, it don't matter when you come. Because that, I'm going to make it to the shore. And what about you?
Yeah.
I'm going to make it to the shore. I know that.
Yes.
I believe that today from way down in my heart and soul.
Amen.
That I'm going to make it to the shore.
Yes.
Yeah. Well, Thursday morning, 80 years ago, a little better. I believed in God. I'll never forget it. I have to tell you, there's an old man in the country. I don't know why he loved me so, but he did. Great big old fella. On the mortal's bench and trying to get saved. And I can hear him almost now. Put his hands on my head. He come around and he said, Bud, believe God. That's all he had to say. Bud, believe God. Thank God I come to the place that was able to do that.
Amen.
But if you believe God, you'll make it safe to the shore.
Amen.
We don't know what's between there and there, naturally speaking. I know some of them swam to the shore. Some of them went on broken parts of the ship. Well, I'm going to go on a broken part of the ship because I can't swim. But I'm going to make it. One of it is out of my mind. I often tell people, they'll come around out of the casket and look at my, what's left of me and crying and all of that. They look up and thank God that I've come to the place in life that I could believe and that I've come to the end and I've completely, listen, I've completely conquered sin.
Amen.
Through Jesus Christ.
Amen.
I've completely conquered it. Because it says when sin's finished, it brings forth death. How wonderful it'll be that we'll not have to hold out the loved one's hand, which I experienced when the last breath was gone. Her heart beat twice as I had. That was it. But one of these days, simply because that I believed I may not be there again.
Amen.
On the other side of Jordan.
Yes.
Well, preacher, we ain't got there yet. You don't know that. They ain't got there yet. maybe some heartaches and trouble. But you know what? I believe God that He'll take care of them. Like the woman that said, if I could just but touch the hem of His garment, I'll be made whole.
Yeah.
She believed that if she just a little bitty thing, it may be the little thing that you do today. If you believe God will take it and multiply it, bless the hearts of people. He will do that. He will do that. Yeah. We find that the world today, they seemingly make a lot of excuses about the lost people want to come to the church. They don't come like they used to. I preach at church one Sunday morning, I looked back and I counted 21 lost people in the service. People said, well, you can't make them come. I'm going to get on fighting a little bit right here. No, you can't make them. But I know somebody can.
That's right.
I think God's able to make us. The old people, preaching used to preach about conviction.
Yeah.
Praying for conviction. The lost people, if you pray for them to get under conviction, God will need them. Bring them down to the church. If we're just obeying, if we're just believing, then you've done the experience all those. But God is the one who has this law. The revival at Ada Greer Baptist Church, there's a family there, the man bring his family to church. He waited with 300 pounds. The old man, he wouldn't come to church, he lost man. He go down by front of the church to the middle tree, and I'd sit by that tree for some time. Well, church is over with the expanding back home. Revival was going on and I'd send him halfway back the island. He had two daughters, teenagers, that sang in churches, good singing. And one of them was standing close to him and the other took her by the hand, said, come on, let's go. She said, oh, you're going? She said, we're going after Daddy. People tired. That we believe God, that we can take one another by the hand and go after the lost people.
Amen.
Amen. Time not waiting. Surely, here they come with you. One on one side and one on the other. And he got saved. Well, I could tell you the difference from that, with the boy. That they believe God. And what I told that for is to say that it's not impossible to believe God today and realize that He's able to do what He said He'd do.
Amen.
Amen. Yeah.
Somebody said, we don't live in that day no more. Well, you may not, but I do. I believe He's still able.
Yes, He is.
I do. Bring the lost in if we pray for them. And people, we all believe that according to the scripture, the time is just about up. That may be one day, it may be 1,000 years, but with God, it's just a short time. Let's not let the worldly things keep you and I from doing the little things that we can do. If it's just go around and pat somebody on the head and say, believe God, believe Him today with our heart, not with our mind. All of us believe God as far as the natural mind is concerned. The little children, we teach them when they're kids that there's a God and that He still moves and leaves. We believe that naturally. But when you can breathe Him from your heart, He'll save. He'll multiply Atkins Baptist Church. Yes. I believe that this much baby stand here.
Amen.
Stand here. So obey God. Believe Him when you sing the old song. That's so wonderfully blessed. Yeah, as I said a little while ago, it won't be long with me. I have a fun and telling people I know when they're be. When I'll leave here. And I say, now wait a minute, bud, you don't know yet, I do. Mike sang me the old song once in a while, Zion's Hill. And in the course of it, you find these words, when the wheels of mortal life almost stand still, I'm going to dwell in Zion's Hill. When you come along and go with me, people, I'm headed that way. If I never get to preach to you again, thank God for this time. I know it's not been much, it's been scattered.
Been great.
And all of that, thank you for it. Because it's the first time I've got to try in over 5 years. Thank you,
Heaven.
Pleasing to God.
Amen. Thank you, Lord.
Can I say something?
Yes.
Yes, first, I want to thank God that he preached today. I didn't think I'd ever hear you preach again. Daddy, I was worried about the fact that he didn't know where your heart is full. But I was sitting here thinking, if Daddy hadn't listened to God, I would never got saved. You know, brother, Mom and Daddy raised us in church. And I was sitting back here thinking, well, ago, we got these grandbabies coming along. And when Amanda told me, the first thing I said was, God, let me help you more than that, Lord, let me someday come to know you.
Amen.
Yes. I'm thankful I had a mom and daddy that loved me and took me to church.
Amen. Bishop.
Mark's talking to me. Mine's here. I just
wait for me a glad tomorrow. Where gates of pearls swing open wide. And when I pass this veil of sorrow,
with him all the way.
lead you and guide you and direct you. Thank you for preaching the gospel for all of you. Heavenly Father, we thank you, dear God, for this day. We thank you for the sweet blessings of the Holy Spirit of God, Lord, that fills that heart. Lord, I just thank you for passing by this morning and breathing on us. Lord, we just thank you for your presence. Thank you for the power of the Holy Spirit of God, Lord, that sometimes comes out in water in our eyes because of your blessings upon us. Lord, we just ask that you'd go with every home as we go to our respective homes, give us safe journeys there, bring us back at the next appointed time. But Lord, we pray for the Grateful family this morning, Lord. We know, dear God, they're hurting just like the war family was last week. I pray, dear God, that you would just touch them. Give them grace and strength, Lord. Give them that peace that passeth all understanding. Lord, we thank you for Jimmy, for his life. We pray, Heavenly Father, that you would be honored and glorified in his services and his home for his homecoming. And Lord, lead us, guide us, and direct us, and bring us back to the next point in time. In Jesus' name we ask. Amen.
Amen. Amen.